got back in another episode today. We're gonna show. I don't know. I could go close.
Now, I do have to warn you. If Bill sues, he'll end up with everything you've got.
But that's everything I got. Okay, kid. Give me your best worried look. Ooh, that's good worry. Maggie, when we visit Jill, you should think about your mom and me disappearing forever anytime we step behind the wall. Where am I? No, seriously, where did I go? It's so dark in here. Maggie!
Sure is. You could let me scratch your husband.
Sure, but why?
Because you're the lottery ticket I've been waiting for all my life. Bam!
Zing!
Before this goes any further, can you just take one look at our darling daughters?
Mr. Gunderson, they don't let saxophones in the ICU, so I'll just tell you the song I wrote for you. B flat, C, D flat.
If memory serves, you have a son. Where's he at?
I'm here to give Mr. Gunderson his shot.
Boy, the putting him in a coma idea was just dinner table chatter. I did not sign off.
Tapped your nose.
I was scratching it.
Well, I gotta put something in a coma.
Why, you little...
Gal, I'll see you at court. Zing!
Cha-cha-cha. Cha-cha-cha. That's hopeful.
Cha-cha-ching! Oh. Ron and my client had just turned his life around. His daughter recently bought a washing machine and promised him the box to live in.
Do you think they'll send Dad away forever?
Oh, no, sweetie. They just want all our money.
Will they send us to live with other families?
Miss Simpson, from now on, we will live with us, receiving musical instruction. It's for our sax himself.
Only be associated with beautiful music.
We'll be free to do whatever we want. $1,000 a kidney. Take them both.
Yeah. Ay, caramba.
Mr. Simpson, you deliberately ran your car into my paycheck. My client. No, paycheck is better. What possible defense could you have?
I had no other choice. I didn't want to hit a dog.
You saved a dog? People love dogs. This is our key to winning this case.
You're on my side, right?
I am.
Woohoo!
Now go ahead, son. You tell us how you got your dog.
It was Christmas, sir. We saved him, and he saved us. Now we love the dog, and the dog gives us all the love we could handle. Love.
Aww. Could the stenographer read that last part back with sentimental music?
The dog gives us all the love we could handle. Love.
Thus, the defendant asks this court to believe that in order to avoid hitting a dog, it is acceptable to hit a human? My client?
It's looking good, homie. According to our consultant, the toughest nut to crack is juror number 6.
Aww, good dog.
Ladies and gentlemen, this man is a human being just like you or me. Surely his life has more value than some creature that scoots its buttocks along the ground.
Oh.
Or gets its head stuck in an empty pickle jar.
Oh.
Or walks on a hot sidewalk in a way that suggests it's dancing.
Oh.
This is ridiculous. I'm a human being here, not some dumb animal.
Who are you calling dumb? The dogs who sniff for bombs at the airport? The St. Bernards who save lives on the slopes of St. Maurice? Or this one?
Now
I have a brief instruction.